Carlos Ramirez, owner of Nvs Audio in Roselle, New Jersey. Jasper brought his Indian Challenger up for us to work on. He spent the week up here with us, with his wife, and he let us go over the bike. The previous shop did the install, and they couldn't interface with the factory radio, so they gave him a Bluetooth streamer going directly to the amps, so he couldn't use his navigation, couldn't use his handlebar controls, and the amplifier they use is so large, it had to go in the saddlebags. So we took everything out, did an Nvs Audio Stage 3, two evox 800s in the fairing. We know these bikes pretty good, so the Indian radio is not the easiest radio to interface with. It's a lot harder than interfacing with the Harley radio. So we have a couple of tricks on things to do to get these radios to work. So we have no turn on or turn off pop. We have plenty of voltage coming from the factory head unit. We have completely flat signal going into the DSP. So on this one, we went with a Cicadia DSP, two sound digital evox 800 amplifiers, all three mounted in the fairing. We used a water cover because the fairing of the Indian Challenger gets a lot of water in it, a lot. So we had to cover the amps to keep them protected. We went with Hertz SX165 in the fairing. He had 8-inch lids already, so we went with the Ground Zero Yellow Basket Coax 8s to get as much mid-bass as possible, and some Hertz 200L 8-inch mid-bass drivers facing the rear wheel. This thing came out really, really good. He is super excited and happy about the sound. He's even happier now that he gets to keep his factory thumb controls, navigation works, Bluetooth works, everything through the factory touchscreen. The touchscreen is one of the reasons he bought this newer motorcycle, and not being able to use it was a huge disappointment for him. But we got everything going for him. The bike sounds great, and he's back home. They used all really good equipment, but amplifiers in the bag, and he's having issues with the bag shaking, intermittent audio from the RCA's wiggling loose. So we're gonna pull this out. We're gonna do amps in the fairing. Only things gonna be in the bags is the speakers. So getting rid of this, upgrading those, moving that amp. It's a really good amplifier. I guess the client could use it for his car because it's too big to fit in the fairing. Then just small little upgrades. We're gonna make it work a little bit better for him. And most importantly, using the radio as a source. So we removed all the equipment and started fresh. The client now has audio through the factory screen. So now he can use his navigation, Bluetooth, handlebar controls work again. We upgraded the front speakers to hertz. There was nothing wrong with the DD audio that was in there, but I like the frequency response of the hertz better. It's got crisper highs in my opinion. Then in the bags, we changed out the eights to the ground zero yellow basket because I wanted something with more mid bass. The bike lacked a lot of mid bass. And then we swapped the grills to more factory looking grill. Hertz 200L mid bass driver in the bags. And we moved the amplifiers to the front. We had to go with sound digital amplifiers because the amp they had in here was too big. So now there's no amplifiers in the bags at all. The bags have quick disconnects, so they're removable. Gave him all his equipment back. The Stinger amplifier is a very, very good amplifier, but it's just way too big to fit in the fairing when we got the two Sound Digital evox 800s. So we have Cicadia DSP here, evox 800 here, evox 800 here, factory amplifier in the center, and everything fits back together. No obstruction of the windshield. The windshield still goes up and down. She's all set to go.